afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Pure Pet Panto, Whittington. Just a few housekeeping rules. Firstly, no smoking in the building itself, so if you want to go outside for a cigarette, can you do it in the interval, and make sure you go outside. Or same applies if you want to vaporise yourself. If we hear the word fire, then if you could take three steps, the first ones would be as big as possible and then you'll get out quicker. Exit here where you can see the green emergency lights. There's also an exit in the door that you came in, and there's an exit at the back here, so if you go through the bar you can get out into the back of the car park that way. Okay. The only other thing, just as most of you are local and I'm sort of local, just need to let you know that I'm starting a new business in the new year, which might be of use to people, a bit of an advert really. I'm cleaning mirrors. I can see myself doing it. It gets no better. See what I mean?
Are you sure that's a good idea, Master? I mean, you're not over clever. Just look at what happened with your last job as the church window cleaner.
Well, it's not my fault. They told me to get rid of all the stains.
But not the stained glass.
Oh, well, there's nothing to keep you. Now I split with my girlfriend.
Aww.
Well, every time I saw her, she'd say, "Hi, Ina," and all she did was laugh her head off.
Well, if you've made your mind up, then we best set off.
Right, which way is it to London?
Oh dear, I can see this ending in disaster. Come on, follow me, Master.
Oh, who's this coming down here? Good day to you, sir.
Good day to you too.
Are you coming from London?
I am, sir. I'm much glad to work in the place.
What is that, sir?
It is an awful place, overrun by gangs of wild children, plunder and steal. They call them sewer rats.
Oh dear, but we're off to London to seek our fortune.
Well, I must bid you farewell. I'm going through my way.
Did you hear that, Master? Are you sure you still want to go on? And you almost forgot, Master, to tell them who you are.
That's right, Puss. Now then, so you don't forget me, every time I come on stage, I'm going to say, "Is that the bells of London town I can hear?" And you can say, "Ding dong." Should we give it a go? Is that the bells of London town I can hear?
Ding dong.
Is that the best you can do? Let's give it another go. Is that the bells of London town I can hear?
Ding dong.
Once more. Is that the bells of London town I can hear?
Ding dong!
Right, don't shout, I'm not deaf! Right, let's get to London, Puss.
Come on, follow me, Master, but I can see this ending in tears. Come on, gang, the faggot don't like to get waiting.
That's true, we need to get our instructions for the day.
I hope you don't have that awful bit of time for them.
Nah, even me and Mom, sure. Still, as long as we sleep together, we'll be alright. Ain't that right, gang?
Yeah!
One way, I know of one way. Let's unite and right this wrong.
Yeah.
a little joke, my dear, just a little joke. It means relieving persons of items they no longer require. Ain't that right, Fancy?
If you say so, Faggin. But I still say it ain't right, having these kids do your dirty work.
Oh, shush your pretty mind, Fancy, shush your pretty mind. I calls it education, so I does.
What's education, Faggin?
It's teaching you to become fine, upstanding citizens.
What's upstanding, Faggin?
Oh, God, blimey, don't you kids know nothing?
Ah, could they, Faggin? They don't go to school no more, seeing as their orphanage accidentally burnt to the ground.
Well, at least I was able to rescue them and give them food and shelter.
Shelter? You call it an old shelter? I've seen better stables.
Is that where horses are,
Francie? Yeah, that's right, dear.
My teacher once had a horse, he called it Treacle.
That's a funny name, why did he call it Treacle?
Because it had golden stirrups.
Kit, stick down, kick the noise down, before I swipe you on.
Now then, if I get another hit a kid with glasses.
Nah, you're right. I'll hit on my shirt!
Calm down, the kids, calm down. Bill will be here soon. And you know he don't like hilarity.
What's hilarity?
Oh, hilarity is what Bill don't like, so keep the noise down.
Where is
Mr. Wright, Faggin? He's up time sussing out the prospects. And before you ignorant lot ask, prospects is what we will be working with later.
Well, I still say it ain't right, Faggin.
Fancy, I'll warn you just one more time to keep it set. These kids don't know no better.
But they deserve a proper education.
Well, this is the only one they will get.
Entertaining some foreign gent, and he's sending a stupid cook out for food and wine. She'll be on the strand around 11 a.m.
Ah, a job for the sewer rats, eh?
Oh yes, but I'll be there to make sure they hands over the purse.
Yeah, Bill, your favourite.
What are you after, Ed? There ain't nothing here for you, so clear off!
Right, shall we send Don and Reg in front to the concession area for pillars, Bill?
Good idea, they can get ready and go on in front.
Right, you have that one in red. You get ready, I'll get them ready. Now what's the rest of the plan?
After I get them off from Ron and Rich, I will send the rats out into the strand. They can cause havoc by knocking hats off and stealing wallets and purses. But leave the cook to Ron, she's the one with the rich pickings.
Right, Ron and Rich, you go out front, suss out, see if there's any peelers about. If it's clear, report that to Bill, and he'll send you rats out to cause mayhem.
What's mayhem, Faggins?
Oh, blimey, I think you're right, Fancy. These kids ain't educated like what I is.
Me to get in amongst the tops and be a nuisance.
Easy.
Ron and Reg, you look for the Prime Minister's cook.
What's she look like?
You won't miss her. She's rather big and wearing very bright clothes. But she could be accompanied by a stern-looking butler.
Right, which is what?
The lips of person brings it to me.
There you are, kids. An easy job.
You kids get back here as quick as you can and we can share out the spoils.
Will we get to share this time?
My dear. The rewards you will get will be the food and lodgings I so generously provide.
Well, we ain't had no breakfast yet.
You'll get it later when you get returns.
Will it be something nice, Faggot?
Shall we see. Shall I get Fancy to cook you up a stew?
No, Dr.
Zell. Yeah!
Come on, you're wasting time. Run away to get moving and join us in a minute.
Here, Bill. Do you want me to come with you to look after the kids?
Why not? You can keep the little brats from getting under my feet.
Oh, don't say that, Bill. They don't mean no harm.
Oh, don't worry, Fancy. Everything will be all right.
Come on, kids, get moving and join us in a minute.
Listen, I still say it's wrong, Faggin, and you know it.
Enough, Fancy. We need these kids.
I just wish you didn't have to use them for thieving. They was innocent kids once.
Best of being mad.
soon have enough to sail away, take all the kids with us, out of this dreary hole.
What do you mean, Fag End?
Let's just say I have a plan to leave all this behind.
Oh, that sounds good.
Off you go, Fancy. You join the kids. I have a plan, all right, but it don't include anyone else. Soon we'll have enough wood to carry. And I will sail off to visit my good friend, Senora Fencio, on her sun-drenched island. Leave them all marooned there in the sun. It'll be good for the kids, you know, better for their health. Then I'm going to sail back with all the loot, and I shall be a very rich man. I'll do all for myself, all in all of the money, every little bit. I don't care about those lot, I don't care about those lot.
Eat my food, swine. He ate out every night, that's why it was so expensive.
Well, Esselentian is lucky to have you.
Oh, thank you, but it's not easy being so short-staffed.
I'm so hard to find good staff.
Oh, never mind. What do you think we need? Lots of fresh vegetables?
I can eat a few tatties and roots.
If you say so.
That I do. And a few turnips that we harvest in the banquet fit for a king.
Oh, well, the master did say that the guests were from overseas.
Overseas, eh? What is it, Ratatouille?
I am not serving rats!
No, Ratatouille is a French root vegetable dish.
Oh, no, I don't like the sound of that. I think we'll stick with good old boiled beef.
Well, so we need a butcher and a grocer.
Oh, yes.
Well,
You did work in that vet.
Oh, the vet! That's right. It was so small in that vet, you couldn't swing a cat round. So they got rid of me.
And then it was the auto trades.
Yeah, I worked in a car showroom. And this cowboy came in one day and he said, "Howdy." And I said, "No, BMW. So I got the sack from there as well.
Well, where did you live?
Me and Puss lived with my mother. When we left, she was digging a big hole in the garden, filling it with water to use in the kitchen. She called it a pond, but bless her, she meant well. And her sister used to come round and spin round and round in the garden. I'd say, "Oh my giddy aunt." Yes, me and my family were very poor. Aww. We were poorer than that. Aww. Me and my two brothers and my mum and dad used to share one jumper.
Oh, you were a close-knit family.
She died, she'd leave us her two houses. I used to say, "Premises, premises."
Look, how would you like to come and work for the Prime Minister? You can help me in the kitchen.
Oh, that'd be really cool.
It says to me, well, there's no heating in the servants' quarters.
But what about my puss?
Oh, she'd be more than welcome. We need a good ratter.
Sounds ideal, Master.
Right. If you come round to this address, be there for 3 o'clock. Come round to the servants' quarters, we'll meet you there.
Oh, will do, and thank you very much.
Well, that was a stroke of luck, wasn't it, Puss? Let's have a quick get round and then get ready to be at this house at 3 p.m.
Foreigner arriving.
Ah, you mean Samuel Phileas, sir.
What did you call him?
I didn't call him, sir.
No, what's the fellow's name?
Oh, Samuel Fidlier, sir. He's the King of Benidorm, yes, sir.
Jolly rum name, if you ask me.
Well, he has requested an audience, sir.
We haven't got an orchestra.
No, sir, not an orchestra, an audience.
He wants to meet that lot.
Again, sir, no, sir. He wishes to meet you in private.
It seems a bit fishy.
He wants to go fishing with me.
Oh, he wishes to meet with you for a private discussion. It all seems a little strange.
Quite. You don't know what it's all about.
I have no idea. How about you, pardon?
What?
Oh, I was addressing pardon.
I believe he has something of value to discuss with you, sir.
Well, shouldn't I be here then if it concerns the country's reserves?
Preserves? He wants to talk about marmalade.
Again, sir. No, sir.
Oh, well, I'll meet with this fellow, see what he wants, and tell you all about it later. That sounds reasonable enough for a panto. Help you, Senor.
Senor, I have something of huge value which I wish you to keep safe for me.
Really?
Yes, it is, how you say, rarer than the poo of the rocking ass.
I'm sorry, could you repeat that?
You have to say it. Rarer than rocking ass poo.
Oh, yes. Yeah, I think the word should be horse.
It's what I said. Ass.
Yes, well, let's move swiftly on, shall we? But tell me, Sonia, what do you have that is rare, that is incredibly rare?
Moment.
I'm sorry, sir, this is not the place.
It is to show you my pride and joy.
I will call security.
Here, this is it. The only sample of plutonomia in the world.
Pluto what?
Plutonomia. It is one of the most rare minerals in the world, and it is worth 100 billions of your pounds.
Good heavens, that's more than our country's gold reserves.
So, and I am here in this country on a secret mission to sell this to the highest bidder.
What are you doing here? We can't afford it.
Oh, no, I know. I need somewhere to keep it safe overnight. And I do not trust your banks. They are as crooked as the mafiosa.
You have a point, Senor.
So, my friend, I come to you to ask the favor. Would you keep this in your safe overnight for me?
Of course, Senor, not a problem. No one would dare to try to rob number 10 Dining Street.
Ah, excellent, Prime Minister. And is your safe here?
Yes, come, come, come. Have you showed it? Okay,
so, oops.
Trick
to your
good heavens, girl, why didn't you knock?
Because you never heard me, sir.
Fair enough, just put them on the table, will you? There you go. You sure I can persuade you to stay for a drink or maybe a spot of lunch?
Oh, I'll regret. I must depart now, but perhaps tomorrow when I call again.
That'll be excellent. Let me get my man to show you out. You rang, sir? Yes, I had to. The bell was out of order. Will you show the senor to the street, please, Plum, and ask Mrs. Dumpling to come in.
Until tomorrow, Prime Minister. Thank you so much. Thank you.
There you go. No point in wasting it.
You inquired after me, sir?
Yes, Mrs. Dumpling. I'm afraid our guest isn't staying for lunch, so you will have to cancel the banquet.
Oh, but I was looking forward to creating something unique.
I know all your cooking is unique, Mrs. Dumpling.
Oh, why, thank you, sir. Now, can I get you something instead?
Oh, how about just something light?
Something light? Oh, how about a helium sandwich?
Very funny, Mrs. Dumpling.
Oh, sorry, sir, I'm feeling pleased with myself on two counts.
And what are they?
The first, I've had a world-famous cookery writer come to do a piece on my main courses.
Oh, how excellent! Whatever did they say?
It's all quite strange, really. I served him my speciality, leg of salmon, and he sat there with his hand in a bowl of alphabet soup saying he was struggling for words.
Oh dear, and then what's the second point?
Oh, I think I found this a new kitchen boy.
Oh, how wonderful. Does he have the right credentials?
Well, he stopped me from being robbed in the street, so...
Oh, I'm sure that'll make him an excellent asset, Mrs. Dumpling.
I hope so. But now, what time would you like your lunch, sir?
Oh, let's have a look. Give us half an hour. I need to see Watson's pardon in the cabinet room.
Oh, well, would you like me to serve it in there?
Oh, what a great idea, Mrs. Dumpling. Make it so. Let's get cracking.
No, I'm not doing pork.
Now
we go.
Interesting. And how big is this thing you said?
Just a small package. It could be diamond or something.
Well, being in a couple of rats might have to visit number 10 tonight, methinks.
See, I done good, Bill. Now you let her go.
No way, my girl. Let's just see who's telling the truth first. And one more thing. You make sure that kitchen door is locked when everyone else is going to bed, right?
Then will you let her go?
We will see. Now off he goes. Ha ha, let her go. You must be joking. You're too valuable to me, my girl. So I'm afraid your poor little sister will be staying with me for a little while longer.
Centre because my so-called assistants often get on my nerves. Oh, talking of which, let me call Dick. Dick! Dick! I'm looking for Dick! He's just coming now. There you are. Right, you need to prepare our table ready for the ocean pie. Well, I have a chat with our guests, tell them all about my career as a cook. Oh, dear ladies and gentlemen, it didn't start off very well. I'm afraid I got the sack. I stole from a top restaurant. But I stole a kitchen utensil. But I consider it a whisk worth taking. I soon had my own restaurant, and I had two choices on the menu, take it or leave it. And I used to do a lot of experimenting with cooking with wine. Sometimes I'd even put it in while I was making. But then I went abroad and decided on a career change and ended up working in a French cheese factory. Oh dear, I left the oven on one night and there was a huge explosion. Oh, there was debris everywhere. So I packed up and I came home and I settled down. But my husband was never very supportive of my cooking. I remember him saying, "And what are you burning for me tonight?" What a surprise when it turned out to be his clothes. I do like making surprises for everyone. Although the last one was ruined when the fire truck turned up.
Is that the bells of London Town I can hear?
Ding dong!
Right, you've got all the items ready, Chef.
Oh, good. I think they were starting to walk out with my jokes. Right. Have you ever worked with food before?
Well, we haven't been trusted around it.
Well, what sort of experience do you have?
Well, my last job was as a painter and decorator. We painted this room a sort of bluey-green colour.
Oh, so?
Yeah, I'm certain.
What happened?
Well, puss chased a mouse and got paint all over the carpet, so we were asked to leave.
Well, where did you live?
We live with my mother. She's a very famous hairdresser. She once went to the palace to do the Queen's hair.
Did she have a permit?
No, just a bit of a trim off the back.
Well, okay. Well, let's hope this is more successful. If it is, this could be a job for life.
And can that be? I've already lived 20 years in it.
If you say so. Right, but what we need to do is we need to transfer the egg whites from these bowls into these ones, okay? And then we can start making the pastry. So if you just take a little bit of...
Stop!
Professor. We appear to have got carried away.
Well, Master Dick, this isn't a good start to your career, is it?
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I'll make it up.
Look, let's all calm down and settle this with a nice cup of tea.
Good night, Master. Sleep well.
Good
night, Puss.
Services.
We've been robbed. We've been robbed.
Whatever is the matter, Silas? What's all that noise?
We've been robbed, Adrian. Since over the night, they've taken the safe.
What? When? How? Why? Who? Why?
All of us, quick. I must go be the Prime Minister.
The thief themselves!
don't think so. I can't think of anybody, can you?
Oh, wait a minute. Where's that young
Jack?
I haven't seen him all morning.
Oh, well, he's fast asleep in the kitchen. Oh, absolutely exhausted he is.
What? Asleep? Under the kitchen table? Where the door is left open? Let me out here.
He does have a point there. Right
away.
Well, let's hope this solves the crime.
Yeah.
Nothing. I've never been very successful in love. I don't know why. My last husband was horrible to me. I remember saying to him, tell me something that'll make me happy and sad at the same time. He said, you're a better kisser than your sister. Are there any single men in the audience? Oh yeah, okay. No single men in the audience. That's a surprise, just my luck. What about any unhappily married men in the audience? No? Oh, I'm sure I can find a few. I'm sure I can find a few. Oh, there's a very attractive young man here. Don't worry, James, I'm going to be I'll settle for glum.
Well, here we are. Worst time in London. If he tried to now, he'll be here.
Wait, are you sure it's safe, Miss Knuckle?
Don't worry, dear. They won't ask me here. They know Knuckle.
What exactly is your business, Mr. Knuckle?
Beat it.
So where do you suggest we start then?
The worst cabin, the bucket of blood.
Oh, this should get better.
Yeah.
Don't worry, they'll only be the fish guys in this early.
Excuse me.
Yes, very well. Lead on.
Who goes there?
Only a poor serving wench, sir. I have a message for you.
Blimey, it's fancy. Let's go.
A message?
Yes, sir. There's a message for you from the bloke that you're looking for. He's got information about the real villains.
He's the real villain?
No, he's not the real villain. He's only a few yards away, but he wants a fair urine.
Oh, my God. If he comes here, he might be able to escape. I think we should hang around.
Aye, that's a good point. Bring him to us, miss. Bring him to us. Where are the Knuckle Brothers?
Well, who really cares? They brought us to the right place.
What, you promised us to bring a fair year in?
Yes, 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 we promise. Can you believe he's got Mrs. Dumpling as a hostage?
Oh, is this some kind of trick? You villain?
No, no, there's no trick. Hear him out.
No, I'm here to prove my innocence. I did not steal your treasure, but I know who did.
Oh, hang on a bow. Is that the bells of London Town I can hear?
Ding dong!
It was that evil Bill Spike that did it, and his evil henchman Faggin broke into your home and stole the safe.
And I have a witness. Yes, sir. You see, they kidnapped a gang of kids and they have sailed away to an island off the coast of Italy. It's called Salonia. And they're meeting there to a wicked friend of Faggins called Signora Fencio.
And I volunteer to get a boat and man an expedition to capture the villains and return the treasure to you.
And I will be your ratter.
Wow, but how do we get there?
I hear that Faggin gets his tickets from a counterfeiter called Freddy the Forger who works out the bucket of blood. Shall I go and fetch it?
Yes, do get it now.
Oh, how exciting! Oh, we're going on an expedition. Who's going to go with you?
Well, I must lead, of course, and must take young Dick with me. I've taken quite a shine to young Dick of late. Yes.
And as I said before, I will be your ratter.
Oh, and you're going to need somebody to cook and prepare all your food on this expedition.
Of course, Mrs. Dumpling, you must come too.
And I know where Signora Fencio has her base. And I can look after the children when we call all the villains.
Oh, that is vital to have on board.
You'll need someone to let it close every morning.
Oh yes, my pants do get rather crispy after a couple of weeks. He must have too. Yes. I'm not the only one, obviously.
About us, sir. What about us?
Oh, you two need to stay here. I need you to run the country while I'm gone. Stall that King of Benidormia for however long it takes.
Well, that suits me. I'm very good with the water. I get ill stepping over a puddle.
Same here, but we will keep the country strong and stable, sir. Yeah.
I've heard that somewhere before. Oh, off you pop. Thank you, gentlemen.
Here he is, and he has an interesting tale to tell.
Well, look, it wasn't my fault, right?
Come on, Freddy, tell your tale.
Look, Spike comes to me and says he wants a boat and a crew to take him to Sidonia. Oh, it's no big deal. A fag end's done it hundreds of times.
Well, when did they sail?
Ah, right, they sail today, on the next high tide.
Then they're not that far in front of us.
No, so when's the next boat?
Ah, well, there isn't one, unless you crew it yourselves.
Then we'll have to.
Do you have experience of boats, then, Dick?
Yes, I once entered a competition to put sails on a boat.
Oh, did you win?
No, it rigged.
This is wasting time. Freddy, please find us a boat quickly.
Oh, I don't know.
Freddy?
Right, I'll see what I can do.
Right. Dick, go on. I need to get provisions. You two come with me.
What about my purse and Nancy?
Oh, well, they can come as well. More hands make light work.
You know, I never trusted my hands. That's why I always keep them at arm's length. Please, sir, could this poor young maid come with us? She's very worried about her sister.
Yes, of course, you may come too. But after that, no more freeloaders.
Shame you didn't say that when you were forming your government.
I found a boat with a skipper and a crew, and they could sail on the next high tide, which is tomorrow.
What does that mean?
Well, it means you've got 24 hours to get yourself sorted and get down to Tilbury. Good luck to you all.
Time and tide waits for no man!
Very true, Mrs. Dumpling. Where do you get your knowledge?
Oh, well, I'm an avid reader of the newspaper. Take today, for example. Did you know a courtroom artist has been arrested? Not sure why. Details are a little sketchy. Did you know that the most popular song in the charts at the moment is about tortillas? Well, I say pop song, it's more of a rap. And in the Hereford Times on Thursday, there was an advert for burial plots. Well, that's the last thing I'll need. And then in the Kilpeck Good News, they've arrested two people. One for eating batteries, one for eating fireworks. They've charged one, let the other on fire!
Aren't we wasting time?
Come on, let's get this expedition going. We're all in this together. Come on.
Thank you.
Laura, for your many guests, and I have that at my best.
What is the goal? What is the goal? Now you might just show we have plenty of the vino, huh?
Well, plenty of vino is already, Signora, as is my charming smile.
Okay, now I understand. The crazy English have landed, huh?
It's a good dog. The English ladies, they can't resist.
Now listen, Gino, I need you to have a private talk over these men, you understand?
Signora, I am reserving your special table for you while I entertain the ladies.
Oh, Gino, it is just the English villains and their bambinos. There are no ladies.
What? No ladies? To enjoy my charms?
No, it is a trip! No!
Mamma mia! I'm so beautiful!
Save
all my charms for the ladies. Take a selfie so I can gaze at my Bella body in a picture.
Buongiorno, gentlemen. You have not brought your lady today?
Nah, she ain't come this time.
Oh, just a pity. I have something in my trouser for her.
What's that you say?
It is in my pocket. It's a bottle of a special herbal medicine that she discussed with me last time she was here.
Oh, I see, we're getting on to it.
All right, it's safe to come out. Why are they hiding? There's nobody here.
Oh,
oh
I suppose. Come on then. Come on, guys. Come on. Quick. Hurry up. Senora Spiker, she wanted me to meet you.
It seems too quiet. You were safe, kids. No one is here to harm you. Except me, if you'd be Mr. Haven.
On sausages.
And you ain't got no bangers.
And
jumping those. They're so fussy, aren't they? Eh? I've never met such fussy children.
Mamma mia!
is magnifico!
What do you reckon then? How much are you going
to
pay?
Well, I would have to think about this.
Ah, take your time, Squire. We've got lots of time.
Oh, signor.
Yes,
why not get us some more of your vino?
And of course, Gino.
Okay.
Gino!
Signor, did you see him from?
I didn't. It's a man far away.
Are you yellow, signor?
Yeah, he's a more wine or vino for getcha.
Si. You like it for me to pour the vino, gentlemen?
While you look at my bella body.
Lord, thank you. We can pour it ourselves.
You not want to look at my bella body
no,
either?
Gino, just go. Do something with your hair.
No, I need to give it a wash.
Yes, you do. Mamma mia, where did you get him from?
Oh, he's very, very cheap. All he wants is a plate of spaghetti with a bed and, a phone note to take a selfie with.
Come on, he's wasting time. What's your value for this package?
Well, I need to speak to Signor Fenzio, but in private.
Oh, I suppose so. Come on, we'll give you half an hour. We'll go off and have some nosh with the kids.
Hey. Do you think we can talk in front of the audience?
Can we trust you?
I'll not say anything to anybody.
Can we trust you?
Yes.
You won't tell anybody?
No.
What do you think?
Well, it's the same package. They must have stolen it from the safe in London.
So, what is the plan?
Well, I will offer them £2 million. Then I take the Pluton from Donomia. I go home to Benidormia. Then I go to London, and there I demand £100 billion in compensation.
Oh, okay. And what is my part?
£10 million.
Oh, these are not too much compared with what you make up.
But it's more than one cup.
But I brought it all together.
Oh, okay. I offer you a bonus.
Okay. What is this bonus?
£10 million plus a seasonal ticket for the Arsenal.
I'll just take the £10 million.
Oh, gentlemen, we have agreed a price.
Good. How much are you going to pay then?
I can offer you £2 million. I'm very busy, man. It's final offer.
Very generous, sir. I think so. Find it acceptable.
Oh, that is good. Okay, I go get the money. I see you here tonight.
That's fine. We'll be right here.
So, gentlemen, it's been a good day, no?
Indeed, Signora, a good day, yes.
Yeah, I think you'll find me is all very happy.
Would anyone like a more vino?
No, thank you.
Will they be a picture with me?
Yes, no.
Oh, this boat trip is taking forever. And now we've hit customs clearance problems. Damn Brexit. Right, while we wait to clear customs, we're going to announce the raffle. So, can you get your raffle tickets out?
Okay.
Might be a special prize for any gentleman named. Okay, the first ticket. It's 519 white. 519 white. Yellow. 624 581 yellow. Oh, there's a special prize comes through this one, John. 533 white. 553, sorry. 553 white.
Can't get the staff.
576 white. Alan, 576 white. Others down here. 456 yellow. Down front here. 621 pink. 650 pink. 625 pink.
Shake him up a bit.
670 pink. 670 pink. Alan? No, 670 pink. We'll put it back to the minute. If anybody finds it, collect it at the end. 421 white. 421 white. Oh, right down the front.
Oh, you've got a nice red tractor.
637 yellow. 637 yellow. Oh, down here. Five, 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 pink. I think. Is it 555 pink? 486 white. 486 white.
You are, it's Bill Drew the Tiger Moth. Very angry. Come in.
620 pink.
Yeah, keep your hand
up. 436 yellow. 436 yellow.
Yes.
520 white. It's down here. And 519 yellow.
Whoa.
Just on the edge. Find the missing one.
670 pink.
670 pink. Last call. Otherwise they go to... it's down here. Oh, I was going to enjoy that.
Some crayons.
Yeah. I need waxing. Let's go see if we've cleared customs.
Thank you.
excitement on. I'm so hot. Oh, I think if I took all my clothes off and roll them out, I could fill a pint pot with all the sweat.
That's pretty thirsty, but that's what a pint I would do.
Potholes on the road, Bob. Oh, it's even worse than Belmont Road.
No way.
Well, perhaps not. Off anyway, where are we?
We can't be far. Well, my nose is ill.
We're only a few miles from the taverna.
Oh, thank goodness for that, Bob. My feet have got blisters the size of manhole covers.
Oh. But we ought to make a bit of a plan. We can't just barge in on them.
You're right, some of you will be recognised.
Well, Fagin and Bill especially know me.
Well, I'm bound to be recognised by somebody.
Oh, and the Rat Gang will know me, but not Fagin and Spike.
Same here, best if you and I go in alone and suss it out.
Good plan. Now, have we overlooked anything?
Oh, do you want to look now?
No, what?
The garden fence.
That's very true, Dick. I didn't know you were a deep thinker.
Oh, yes, we have them often laid away, pondering and pondering. Well, did you know the exit's on the way out?
You're talking of folk on the way out. Has anyone seen Glum?
Oh, dear Silas. Oh, he's coming along with the luggage. Oh, I do hope he'll be all right.
Dear Silas, say, Mrs. Glum, I didn't know you were sweet on him.
Oh, well, I have been on my own for so long.
What happened to your husband, Mrs. Dunkley?
He got caught breaking into McDonald's. In fact, he got caught breaking into McDonald's twice. So they did him for a double cheese burglary.
It's all very well, though. It's not getting the job done. I go with Dick. I suggest Fancy and I stay here behind this conveniently placed bush and wait for Glum, while Dick and Mrs. Dumpling, you go to the taverna and find out what's what.
Well, what will be our reason for visiting the taverna?
Oh, say you're on honeymoon and need a bed for the night.
Oh, my! Oh, me and a handsome young man on honeymoon. Whatever next?
Oh, dear boss, this isn't working out quite like I don't. First thing comes by my side.
Oh, yes, we couldn't go without your pussycat.
Hey, young sir.
You take care, Fancy.
I will, and perhaps we can talk later.
Yes. Well, please call me Dick.
You're a dick.
Yes, please take
care. Looks like someone's got a soft spot for Dick.
This was supposed to be a family show. 10 minutes ago.
Now, we ought to get this plan. Right, Prime Minister, you and I are going to rush and wait for Glum. You two and the cat. You walk down to the burner and find out what you need to find out.
And we'll come back later and tell you what we've sussed out. Let this fight begin.
And all those things I do say.
mum.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes. And don't forget, we're on honeymoon. Oh, I nearly tripped over your...
Spike's room. He hardly ever leaves it.
I'm getting there.
Yes, senor, has he said the room are not ready yet? Would you like a mojito?
Oh, yes, please.
Hey, Gino, you get back in the bar, you lazy man, huh?
You want a mojito?
Quickly, put it on the table.
Is the room ready?
Not quite. We're having to strengthen the bed. Your lady, she is a little bit bulky.
Bulky? Bulky?
I'll have you know I'm considered in my prime.
Oh, come on a bit, you're a bit fat. Oh, please, there's nothing wrong with being big. Perhaps being fatter runs in your family.
No, she's fat because no one runs in her family.
I'll have you know I have a medical condition. Every time I go out running, my feet take me straight into the nearest chip shop.
Oh, then perhaps you need to go on a diet.
I am on a diet. I want to lose 10 pounds this year.
What?
And I've only got 12 to go.
I don't. You enjoy the meal. I check on your room, huh?
Puss! Wish you'd stop doing that.
What have you found out now? Well, the children are staying in two dormitory rooms, and there are three men staying here as well.
And which room is the stolen minerals?
I think it'll be in Bill Spike's room at the end of the corridor.
Oh, no. How are we going to get in there?
Well, you need to cause a distraction.
Fire, the cooker should go up with a cup of smoker.
Well, don't you have extinguishers?
See, do you know, put it out now.
Oh, do you have many fires in the kitchen?
It happens all the time. Whoosh, bang, off they go again. Let's go see if it's out of.
I think this could be the answer.
I'm thinking the same thing. You could cause a diversion by faking a fire in your bedroom.
Oh, I can do that. I'm used to faking things in the bedroom. What do you need me to do?
Do you know what room you're in yet?
No, we're still waiting for the key.
Did I hear you mention the key to your room?
Yes, we were just wondering if our room had a view.
But you're on honeymoon. Why are you worried about the view?
It's because my husband likes to serenade me by the moonlight.
Oh, okay, I see. Well, you have a room at 21. It's down the corridor with a bell of Easter over the sea.
Is anyone else down that corridor?
Oh, now I understand. You don't wish to disturb anybody with your serenading, eh?
Yeah, I can be a bit loud.
Oh, Mamma Mia! Well, don't worry. It's just Mr. Spiker down the end of the corridor. Nobody else will hear you.
Have you got the key?
Oh, yes, of course. Oh, excuse me. There we go. Now, just down to reception. Go along the corridor and turn the right at the picture of Basil Brush.
Right. I'll go into the room. Wait, we'll go into the room. And after a couple of minutes, I'll come out yelling, fire, fire!
Yes, and I'll go in, and when everyone's out, I'll get the stolen minerals.
But what about me?
You go back and get nervous. We'll need reinforcements to capture these villains.
Right, sounds like a plan, Master. See you later.
See you later.
Bye, oh, I forgot about the kids' game.
Oh, let's do it now. We'll give Puss a chance to get back and see the others.
Right.
Come on.
I need four children volunteers.
Put your hands up.
There could be a noise in it for you.
Oh, should I come down and finish? Who else wants to do it? Who else wants to do it? Come on. We also need two adult volunteers. Everyone's pointing at you, Jenko. Oh, and James this side as well. Do we have any adult volunteers first? Are you sure? I'm going to come and pick someone. 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 Oh, fine. Future husband, don't you think?
Calm down, Mrs. Dumpling.
Sorry.
Right, now you've got to get on your knees.
Oh, sorry.
Not you. Right, because we're in Italy, we're playing a game called Mummy Mia, okay? So you have to make mummies out of your adults. Right? And don't waste it, come from lots, it's really expensive.
She's got a toilet roll.
Toilet roll. And then the audience are going to decide which is the best mummy at the end of the game, right? So we'll help you, Mrs. Dumpling, you help them.
Oh, with pleasure.
Ready?
On your marks, get set, go!
Thank you.
cheeky one, isn't she?
Island looks clear, Bill. No prowlers at
that. Not that I can see, just that crazy honeymoon couple.
Oh, they won't do us no harm.
Now, we just home and try back in. Stop dreaming about all that lovely dosh.
Anyway.
these valuables. Hang on a minute. Fancy, what's you doing here? I'm not sure these gents, I recognise them from somewhere.
So you should, you villain.
We ain't done nothing.
No, it's us guys from wrong. Someone has stolen my valuables.
You mean these?
My valuables, he's nicked them.
No, sir, it was you that nicked them, as you put it, nicked from the safe in my residence in Downing Street.
Oh, I mean, it's the Prime Minister.
Yes, indeed. And you stole those minerals that I was keeping safe for the King of Benidormia, whom I mysteriously see is here as well.
It's a coincidence. I was just passing through. But now you can give me my package.
No, sir. I think this is just one huge conspiracy to trick Her Majesty's government into giving you billions of pounds.
I am innocent! Innocent!
We will let the courts decide that. And as a British subject captured the loot, it's now ours. Work for Lord Elgin.
Oh, become a babe!
I don't look good, do it.
No, it don't. Knuckles, could you please escort these villains to the boat?
And don't forget the Signora. She's been fencing their goods for years.
Oh, curses! I would have got away with it if it wasn't for your snooping case.
Well, we shall sell these minerals and use the money to benefit the British people.
Are you sure you're the British Prime Minister?
Please, sir, could we use just a little of the money to build a new orphanage and school for these children?
Of course, Fancy, you can run it if you like. And you, young sir, however can we thank you?
Oh, Mr. Fletcher, I'm just glad I could help.
But I think with your courage and bravery and initiative, good old British spunk, you'd make a jolly good Lord Mayor of London.
What? Silence? We can get married?
Well done, Puss.
No, well done, Master. You did go to London and now you've made your fortune.
Well said, Puss. Perhaps you could become Mouser-in-Chief to Her Majesty.
Why, thank you, sire. Perhaps now we could talk of our future.
Perhaps we could, Fancy, and the bells of London Town might ring out to celebrate our wedding.
Ding dong!
A double wedding!
Ding dong!